So in these surahs, which we started from Surah Al-Zumar, then Surah Al-Mumin, then Surah Al-Sajda, and then we shall be reading today Surah Al-Shura. These four surahs of the Quran are very important regarding this practical tawheed. Now we come to Surah Al-Shura. This is the climax of these four surahs. And here the subject of practical tawheed comes reaches its zenith. What is the zenith of tawheed? The collective system of human life should come under the obedience of Allah, without any exception. Just as a person, as an individual, فَعْبُدِ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينَ, worship Allah, keeping your obedience, absolute obedience, exclusively reserved for Allah. In the same way, this politico-socio-economic system of yours, all aspects of this life must be under the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this we call iqamatu deen, establish the deen of Allah. And this surah is the surah of iqamatu deen. And please note, it's my feeling, maybe you also share with me, if not now, sometime in future, for the Muslim Ummah today, our requirements regarding Quran are somewhat different from the requirements of the Sahaba. The Sahaba previously were mushrikeen, non-believers. We are born believers. Different case. We belong to Muslim Ummah. Although our believing is only verbal, but we are believers. We don't challenge. So for the Ummah of today, the most important and most relevant surah in the Makki Quran is Surah Al-Shura, and most relevant and most important surah of the Madani Quran is Surah Al-Hadid, the last surah of the 27th part. This is my feeling. And as you know, Makki Quran is twice the size of Madani Quran. Madani is one-third, two-third is Makki. The same ratio proportion is there between the size of Surah Al-Hadid and the size of Surah Al-Shura. It has 52 ayat, perhaps. 53. And that has 29, Surah Al-Hadid. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hamim, Ain, Sin, Qaf. Now this is the second surah which is starting with five alphabets. Three in Quran with one. Surah Qaf, Surah Noon, Surah Sad. We have read only Surah Sad up till now. Then there are so many starting with two. Hamim, Hamim, Taasin, Yasin, Taha, two. Then three. Alif, Lam, Mim, Alif, Lam, Ra. Then four, Alif Lam Mim Sad, Alif Lam Mim Ra. Then five, two are five. One was Surah Maryam, Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ain, Sad. And second is this, Ha, Mim, Ain, Sin, Kaf. And now this is unique in this respect, that two ayat of this surah are comprising of Huruf-e-Muqatta'at. Otherwise, either the Huruf-e-Muqatta'at are not counted as a ayah, or if they are counted, that is one ayah, not two. Here it is two. Hamim, Ain, Sin, Qaf, kazalika yuhi ilayka wa ilal lazina min qablik Allahu al-Azizul Hakim. In this way, Allah, who is Almighty, the Wise, sends revelation to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to those who were before you. Now, kazalika, what does it mean? That will come in the last of this surah. Kazalika will be explained in the end of this surah. What is the methodology of revelation? But here, you just wait. But Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had the experience. It was coming to him. So Allah is saying, O Muhammad, just as we are revealing this Quran to you, in the same way we have been revealing our books to the former messengers of Allah. Lahu maafis samawati maafil. To him belongs everything that is in the heavens and everything that is in the earth. وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ And he is the high, the mighty. تَقَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْ فَوْقِهِنَّ The heavens may near, are near to be rent asunder from above. وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ And the angels keep on glorifying Allah with his praise. وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ And they keep on asking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the people who dwell in this earth. And we have read that in detail in Surah Ghafir or Surah Mumin. Ala inna Allaha huwa al-ghafur rahim. Behold, Allah is verily the forgiving, the merciful. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ As for those who have taken for themselves, besides Allah, protectors, Allahu hafizun alayhim. There is no protector. Allah is the protector and watcher over them. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِوَكِيلٍ And O you Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are not a guardian over them. وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ قُرْآنًا Again, كَذَلِكَ In this way we have sent or revealed to you this Qur'an which is Arabic, Qur'an and Arabian. لِتُنْزِرَ أُمَّ الْقُرَىٰ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا So that you warn the mother city, mother town. Umm al-Qura, Makkah, was the central city of Arabia, Arabian Peninsula. And we have read it before also. حَتَّى نَبْعَسَ فِي أُمِّهَا رَسُولًا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has never been destroying any land unless he sent first a messenger to the central town of that area, that locality. So, O Muhammad, you have to warn these people who are living in Makkah first of all. لِتُنْزِرَ أُمَّ الْقُرَىٰ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا And those who are around it. وَتُنْزِرَ يَوْمَ الْجَمْعِ And so that you warn them of the day of gathering when four humanity will gather before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا رَيْبَ فِي In which there is no doubt. فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ One party, one group will be in the garden. وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ The other party or group will be in the blazing fire. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَجَعَلَهُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً And had Allah wished, He could make you or them all one ummah. وَلَكِنْ يُدْخِلُ مَنْ يَشَاءَ فِي رَحْمَتِهِ But the wisdom of His creation is that He has given man the option. You can go this way or that way. إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا So that now He will admit into His mercy only those whom He wishes. وَالظَّالِمُونَ And as for those who are the evildoers, مَا لَهُمْ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ For them there will be no protector and no helper. أَمِ اتَّخَذُوا مِنْ دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَا Have they taken for themselves, besides Allah, protectors? فَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْوَلِيِّ Allah is the only protector. These are your false thoughts. Allah is the only protector. فَهُوَ الْوَلِيِّ فَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْوَلِيِّ وَهُوَ يُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى And He gives life to the dead. وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ And he is powerful over everything. Now, this subject of system. Human life, the collective aspect of human life. One is the personal life. But you know, much more important today is the collective aspect. If there is something wrong in the collective system, its evil spreads throughout the society. So it has to be a just social order. Based on justice, fair play. So, and the first point regarding this is that sovereignty belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, in this ayah now, in this first ayah of the second section, first of all what is established is that the authority to decide matters is with Allah and Allah alone. وَمَا اخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ And in whichsoever thing you differ, فَحُكْمَهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ So authority to decide it is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What should be the rights of the husband? what should be the rights of the wife? There can be different views. What are the duties, responsibilities of a husband? What are the duties and responsibilities of a wife? You may differ, but the decision will be given by Allah. What are the rights of the rulers? And what are the rights of the ruled? Who will decide? If you ask the rulers, they will say, we should have the maximum rights. We have to keep the law and order and this and that, so there should be maximum authority in our hands. As far as the ruled people come up to this, we should have the freedom. We don't want a totalitarian state. We don't want a dictatorship. We want to have something in our hands. Who will decide? What's the point of justice? What's the point of balance? Allah will decide. So these are, in the same way, here is the capital, here is the labor. Capital, it wants its share. It wants to dominate. It demands the lion's share. Labor says, no. Capital itself is nothing. It's our labor that has gained everything. We deserve more. But who will decide? The capitalist would say, will present his case, and the labor would present their case. Who will decide? Allah. وَمَا اخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَحُكْمُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبِّي. He is Allah, my Lord. عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ. I have put all of my trust in Him. وَإِلَيْهِ أُنِيبُ. And to Him I turn my face. فاطر السماوات والارض. He is the originator of the heavens and the earth. جَعَلَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. He has made from your own selves, your species, spouses for you. وَمِنَ الْأَنْعَامِ أَزْوَاجًا. And in the same way for the cattle, there are spouses, species, sexes. Species is the same, but sex is different. يَزْرَعُكُمْ فِيهِ. Due to this difference of sexes, He multiplies you. Procreation. Procreation is through this difference of sex. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ. There is nothing, 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 none, none like Him. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. And He is all-seeing, all-listening. لَهُ مَقَالِدُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To Him belong all the keys of the heavens and the earth. يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. For whomsoever He likes, He outspreads the sustenance. And for whomsoever He likes, He straightens it or restricts it. إِنَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. He knows everything. If He is outspreading, it is also based on His knowledge. If He is restricting, this is also based on His knowledge. There is nothing haphazard. شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ. Now comes the key ayah of this surah. And in this respect, I may say, the key ayah of the Quran. On the subject of اِقَامَةُ الدِّينِ, this is the key ayah of the whole Quran. شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ. For you, O Muslims, O followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have ordained as deen the same thing, مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا, which we had ordained to Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ. And that which we have revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى. And what we had enjoined on Ibrahim and Musa and Isa alayhim salatu wasalam. What does it mean? The deen has been the same throughout. From day one till the last day, deen is the same. What is the deen? Deen comprises of two things. Allah is your Lord and ruler. You have to worship Him and obey Him. And His messenger is His representative. So the obedience to Allah will be through the obedience to His messenger. Now when the messenger was Moses, Whatever commandments came through him, you had to follow. When the messenger was Jesus, whatever commandments came to you through him, you had to follow. And now finally, our messenger is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What we have sent to him, you have to obey. This is the... In principle, there has been no difference whatsoever in deen. There has been difference in Sharia's. We had the ayah in Surah Al-Ma'idah. لِكُلِّنْ جَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجَا. For each ummah from amongst you, we fixed the Sharia and a minhaj. Sharia, the law. The law of Moses was somewhat different from the law of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shariat-e-Muswi, Shariat-e-Muhammadi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The rules regarding the psalm, fasting, in the former Sharia were different. In our Sharia, different. The form of Salah in the former Sharia was different. In our Sharia, it is different. Methodology was also different. In the methodology of Musa, the priority was to get a nation which was oppressed badly, to get freedom for it. That was priority number one. On the first meeting with Pharaoh, the demand was placed. An arsil ma'ana bani Israel. Now let the children of Israel go with us. The methodology of Jesus was different. Methodology of Ibrahim was different. I spoke at this subject at length 2 years before at our annual session of Tanzeem Islami in Karachi. These are the methodologies, minhaj. But minhaj-e-Muhammadi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's a revolutionary minhaj, a revolutionary methodology. Why? The why, answer to the why is coming now. We have understood from this first part of this ayah. شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى. We have ordained you to, for you as a deen, the same as we ordained to Nuh, to Ibrahim, to Musa and Isa, and which we now have revealed to you, O Muhammad. And what is your duty now? أَنْ أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. We have perfected our deen on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. Now it's the duty of the ummah to establish this thing. أَنْ أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. So that you establish this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, actually, practically. And don't differ regarding this deen and iqamatuddin. You can have differences in Sharia. For example, whether when you are praying, should you keep your hands here, or let them loose, you can differ. But in iqamatuddin and deen, the two principles of deen, sovereignty to him, final authority to him, and his obedience through the obedience of the messenger of Allah. This should remain firm. And to establish this system should be your foremost priority. The first duty of a truly believing mu'min is to strive to establish the deen of Allah. If he is not doing it, he has so somehow accepted the deen of batil, taghut. He has reconciled with it. He is at peace with it. He is serving it. He is trying to prosper under it. Then he has no relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالْتَاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ. You have to do kufr with taghut first and then believe in Allah. Unless you do kufr with taghut, you detach yourself from taghut. You might have to live there, but you have to live, which you say, in protest. Living in protest. And taking from that system only the minimum thing which is required for your subsistence. And rest of your time, your money, your resources, your intelligence, your understanding, whatever Allah has bestowed you upon you, should be reserved for the struggle to change this system, topple over this taghut and this nizam-e-batil, and establish the deen of Allah over this earth. An aqimud deen wa la tatafarraqu fih. Now let us complete this ayah. Now before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were two groups. One were the ummiyin, who didn't know what is book and what is prophethood and what is messengerhood and what is sharia. They never knew it. And the other were the people of the book. Regarding the first, Allah says, Kabur ala al-mushrikeena ma tad'uhum ilayh. O Muhammad, it's very hard on these mushrikeen associated with Allah, what you are calling them towards. To give up their false gods, the gods of their fathers, forefathers, their national traditions. How can they do it? So don't think that people will rally around you very easily. You will call and they will come. Oh, no, no. Very hard times are ahead. You will have to work very hard, very hard, very hard. Don't have false hopes that very soon people will accept you. No. Kabur ala al-mushrikeena ma tad'uhum ilayh. It's very hard for these mushrikeen. But you are calling them. Not easy for them to accept. Allahu yajtabi ilayhi man yasha. But there's the ray of hope. Allah chooses for himself whosoever he wishes. Sometimes he chooses himself. Okay, come on. Just as Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he came out of his house with the view to kill Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Drawn out sword in his hand. But then, in the very root, he was told, your sister and brother-in-law, they have converted to Islam. You know this incident, this historical fact. So this is whom Allah is Teba. He was going somewhere else. Allah called him, no, come here, Umar. Don't go that way. And then number two is, وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيبُ. Whosoever turns towards him and wishes to be guided to him, Allah surely will guide him also. So there are two types of persons. One are the persons who themselves seek guidance. For them, the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that he will definitely give them guidance. But there are others also, he might not be seeking, but maybe that Allah pulls them himself using his prerogative, his authority. We had already read ayah number 13 of Surah Al-Shura, but let us again translate it, because the two ayat which are coming after that, they three go to make one group. And to understand the coming two ayat, it's necessary to refresh in your mind what we have read in ayah 13. Shara lakum, for you, O followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have ordained, bin ad-deen, as a deen, ma wassa bihi Nuhan, what we ordained to Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam, wallazi awhayna ilayk, and what we have revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى, and what we enjoined upon Ibrahim and Musa and Isa, أَنْ أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ, so that you establish this deen, وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ, and don't be divided regarding this deen and إِقَامَةُ الدِّينَ. As for those whom you are calling, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, regarding the Ummiyin, the Mushrikeen of Arab, كَبُرَ عَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ. It's very hard, very harsh for them to accept what you are calling them. مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ. اللَّهُ يَجْتَبِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. But Allah will, you know, He will choose and pull towards Him whomsoever He likes. وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيبُ. And He will definitely guide towards Him whosoever wishes to be guided. As for the other group, the people of the book, وَمَا تَفَرَّقُوا إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءُوا الْعِلْمُ بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ. Don't hope that they will accept you Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the idea that these people were ignorant. They never knew any Sharia, any Nabi, any Rasul. But you know these Jews, these Christians, they know Torah, they know Injil, they know all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they say they believe in Allah, and at least, you know, at the face of it, at least the Jews, you know, they are monotheists, they are muwahidun, they are not mushrik at all. And even the Christians, you know, although they are the worst mushriks, but they say one in three or three in one, this is Trinity in unity and unity in Trinity, they also claim that we believe in one God. These are the three aspects of the same Godhead. So there was hope that these people might join and come and respond and accept this deen. But Allah says, no. Don't entertain any such hopes, O Muhammad. Because وَمَا تَفَرَّقُوا إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاهُمُ الْعِلْمِ. They have differed from each other bitterly after the knowledge had come to them. They believe in the same Old Testament, the Jews and the Christians, the same Old Testament. That is common between them. But they are bitter enemies of each other. So, what is the reason? بَغِيَمْ بَيْنَهُمْ. You know, this jealousy among human beings and the urge to dominate, as Adler says, that one of the basic instincts in human beings is the urge to dominate. So, why should we accept their creed? It means they will be above us. Why should I accept what Muhammad is calling for? It means I have to follow him then. I will have to obey him. So this jealousy and this urge to dominate is the reason why people reject, although their hearts testify that this is correct. Because in the case of the Jews, at least for their ulama, the learned people among the Jews, Quran says at more than one places, يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُمْ. They recognize Muhammad and Quran sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just as they recognize their own sons. But still, they were the worst enemies. Why? Jealousy. بَغْيَمْ بَيْنَهُمْ. And actually this subject, that all these, you know, schisms in the world and mankind, they are on the basis of this بَغْيَمْ بَيْنَهُمْ. This subject came in Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah 213, then Ali Imran, Ayah 19, then now here, and for the fourth time it will come in Surah Al-Jasiyah, Ayah 17. This Baghiyam Bainahum is the root cause. The urge to dominate is the root cause. The jealousy among people is the root cause. وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. And had not a word of your Lord passed already for a fixed time of period, period of time, لَقُوْضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ. All matters between them would have been decided. Allah has kept these things for decision, for the day of judgment. Otherwise, in this very world, these things would have been decided. وَإِنَّ الَّذِيرَ أُورِسُ الْكِتَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ لَفِي شَكِّمْ مِنْهُ مُرِيبٍ. And verily those who inherited the books after them, the book was given to Musa and Bani Israel, they inherited. The book was given to Jesus and his Hawariyin, they inherited it. But you know, when those people who inherit the books, after some time, the fi shakkim min humurib, they themselves come in doubts about that book. And you know, very disturbing doubts, they surround them. So you, Muhammad, don't hope, neither these mushrikeen, ummiyin, are going to accept you easily, nor there can be an easy acceptance for you from among the people of the book. But but you keep on calling for this. Perseverance in calling. Istiqamah ala dawa. This dawa, this call should continue, 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 whether somebody is accepting or not. And we have the example that Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam kept calling people for 950 years. We have read it in Surah Al-Ankabut. وَلَبِثَ فِيهِمْ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا. فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَرْضُ. Now count here. These are the commandments coming to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they are the commandments to every da'i, which from among his followers, because this ummah has to go till the end of this world. The Prophet said, أَنَا آخِرُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ وَأَنْتُمْ آخِرُ الْأُمَمِ. I am the last messenger and you are the last ummah. So we have to continue. So people will be coming. and they will call towards the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, walking in the footsteps of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for them also, these are the instructions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For every da'i of deen. فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَدْعُ Number one. You go on calling for this, iqamatu deen. For nothing less. وَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ And you stand and persevere as you have been commanded. You don't swerve due to pressures from this side or that side. These mushrikeen will be pressurizing you. As we saw in Surah Yunus, اَيْتَ بِغَيْرِ قُرَانِ غَيْرِ هَذَا وَبَدِّلْهُ Muhammad presents some other Quran or make some changes in it. This Quran is too rigid. We can't accept it. And in the same way in Surah Bani Israel, وَإِنْ كَادُوا لَيَفْتِنُونَكَ عَنِ الَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ لِتَفْتَرِيَ عَلَيْنَا غَيْرَهُ So pressure would come to you from this side also, from that side also. But, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاهُمْ Don't follow their wishes and lusts. وَقُلْ And say, آمَنْتُ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ كِتَابٍ I have total faith in the book that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent to me. وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ Number five. I have been commanded to establish justice amongst you. This is the most important part of it. That don't think that I am only a sermon giver. No. I have come to establish justice. To do away with all forms of exploitation, all forms of repression, discrimination, injustices, exploitations, and to establish system of justice over here. I come for that. I'm not a storyteller. I'm not a poet. I'm not only a sermon sayer. A wise comes to this locality and he says makes a very good speech. And then he accepts some, you know, something which is presented to him and goes to the other town. And there again he is speaking it. It is his profession. I'm not one of them. Don't take me to be a sermon sayer. أُمِرْتُ لِعَدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ I have been commanded to establish justice between you. Allahu Rabbuna wa Rabbukum. Now as far as your opposition to my mission, Allah is our Lord and your Lord also. لَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ For us will be the results of what we are doing. And for you will be the results of what you are doing. لَا حُجَّةَ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ There is no use of any argument among us. Why to fight? Allahu yajma'u bainana. Allah will gather us together. Wa ilayhi al-masir. Maybe after some time we get together. We can see say these words to the different movements among the Muslims. They are working for Islam. But the methodologies are different. You know, maybe emphasis is different. Some are more emphasizing on the personal characters. Others emphasize more the political aspect, etc., etc. All are sincere. No, nobody, you know, is dishonest. So if we can say to each other, Allahu Rabbuna wa Rabbukum, our Lord and your Lord is the same. Lana amaluna wa lakum amalukum. Whatever we are doing, if they are accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we shall get the reward. If rejected, then we shall be the losers. And if what you are doing, the results will come to you. لا حجت بيننا وبينكم. There is no need of fighting between us. Why this argument? Allahu yajma bainana. Maybe tomorrow, day after, we come together. We agree on some one program. That's possible. Allahu yajma bainana. He might bring us together. Or at least, ilayhi al-masir. One day we shall be standing all before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There we shall be all together. And then everybody should know, will come to know, where he stood. What was his position? How much he was correct and how much he was wrong. So no need of argument and no need of fighting. وَالَّذِينَ يُحَاجُّونَ فِي اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا مَسْتُجِيبَ لَهُ And those, as for those who are arguing concerning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Although his call has been acknowledged by many people, حُجَّتُهُمْ دَاحِذَةٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ Their excuse and argument is void with their Lord. وَعَلَيْهِمْ غَضَبٌ Upon them will come the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ And for them is the severe chastisement. This concerns those peoples who had seen people making sacrifices for the deen of Allah. You know, in the beginning of every revolutionary movement, because people see, it's a hard task, the society will retort, it will come against you, you will be in difficulty. When you say your system is wrong, they will say you have gone crazy. It's all right with our system. We want status quo. So only those people who have extraordinary courage, they care to come forward and say, oh, this is wrong and we want to rectify it. So people who don't have that much courage, they keep behind. But when some people have come forward and they have set examples of courage and how fortitude they show and how much of forbearance they show, then you know the excuse of the others is gone. Now they should see that they are also human beings. They have done this, they have achieved this. So why can't I do it? I am also a human being. So now their excuse is, you know, they are without any weight in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu allazi anzala al-kitaba bil-haqqi wal-mizan. Allah is He who has sent down the book with truth and mizan and the balance. Balance is the symbol for justice. You see, mostly outside the courts, outside the Supreme Court in Islamabad, Pakistan, and High Court in Lahore, we have this picture of a balance. Because balance means justice. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent the book, the law. What's the purpose of that law? To establish justice. Now, if justice is not established, you go on reading law and get sawab, that's all, what's it? This book was not sent for only reading and reciting and getting sawab. You have to establish it. What's use reading it? What will you gain? لَسْتُمْ عَلَىٰ شَيْنْ حَتَّى تُقِيمُ تَوْرَاتَ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لَسْتُمْ عَلَىٰ شَيْنْ حَتَّى تُقِيمُ تَوْرَاتَ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ Say to them, O people of book, you have no position whatsoever unless you establish Torah and Injil. Then you can come to us, talk to us. يَا أَهْلَ الْقُرْآنِ لَسْتُمْ عَلَىٰ شَيْنْ حَتَّى تُقِيمُ الْقُرْآنِ O you people who believe in Quran, you have no standing whatsoever unless you establish Quran. Then pray to us, we shall listen to your prayers. You have thrown Quran on your backs and you go and pray to us. We are not going to listen to your prayers. These prayers of yours will be thrown into your faces. And this is what is happening today. Daily, Dua Qunut in Masjid Nabawi, Masjid Haram both. But to what use? Allah is not listening. Dua Qunut for so long in 1971. What happened to Pakistan? It was split into two. Allah didn't listen. Did you establish our deen? We gave you Pakistan. We gave you the country. We gave you the freedom. What did you do? So this is it. وَالَّذِينَ يُحَاجُّونَ فِي اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا اسْتُجِيبَ لَهُ حُجَّتُهُمْ دَاحِضَةٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَعَلَيْهِمْ غَضَبٌ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ اللَّهُ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ وَالْمِيزَانِ These words بِالْحَقِّ وَالْمِيزَانِ Kitab and Mizan, they have appeared twice in Quran together. In this Surah Al-Shura and then Surah Al-Hadid. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ We send down with our messengers the book and the balance so that people should abide by justice. وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّ السَّاعَةَ قَرِيبٌ And how can you know maybe that hour has come near? That hour when reckoning will be for each person, you know, what you did, what you were required to do and what you actually did. يَسْتَعْجِرُ بِهَا الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهَا Those who don't believe in the hour and the day of judgment, they want to hasten it. Bring it, Muhammad. You have been threatening us for so long a time. Now bring it. يَسْتَعْجَلُونَ بِهَا يَسْتَعْجَلُ بِهَا الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهَا Because they don't believe in it. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مُشْفِقُونَ مِنْهَا Those who believe in Akhirah, in that as-sa'ah, they are fearful of it. They tremble with the idea that they will have to stand before their Lord. وَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ الْحَقِّ, and they know this is the truth, that our will come and that day of judgment will come. أَلَا إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُمَارُونَ فِي السَّاعَةِ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ, behold those people who have doubts about this hour, they have gone very far off astray. Allahu latifun bi ibadihi yarzuqu man yasha wa huwa al-qawiyyul aziz. Now if a person, he accepts this mission for his life, I will live for Allah, will die for Allah, I devote myself for the iqamatul deen, for the establishment of the deen of Allah. Now the ideas come from Satan. What will you eat? What about your family? You are devoting yourself. What will happen to your family, your dependents? Yourself, your children, they need education. You have daughters, you have to get them married. So what has happened to you? You have gone crazy. The answer is here. Allahu latifum bi ibadihi. Allah is very subtly aware of the needs of His servants. He knows. When I devote myself to Allah, He knows what I need. And He will provide me with it. He has all the authority in His hand. How is it possible? You devote yourself to some big chief, for example, some big landlord. Will he not look after your needs? Allah, the Malikul Mulk, if you devote yourself for Him, He will not take care of you. Even you don't know what you need. He knows what you need. We never knew what is vitamin C and what is vitamin E and what is vitamin A. But these things had been provided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have come to know later on that we needed these things. Allahu latifum bi ibadihi yarzuqu man yasha'. He gives sustenance to whomsoever He wishes. Wa huwa al-qawiyyul aziz. And He is the strong and mighty. He can provide you. He can give you sustenance. Man kana yuridu harsa al-akhirati nazid lahu fi harsihi. Whosoever aims at the reward of akhirah. I told you before also. This is the crux of the matter. You want dunya or akhirah? If you want dunya, Allah will give you. Work hard and you will get something. Maybe not everything that you want, but at least, you know, something He will give you. But if you want akhirah, the hereafter, for that you have to work. Man kana yuridu harsal akhirate. Whosoever decides that he needs and he desires the akhirah, the reward of akhirah, nazid lahu fi harsi, we shall keep on increasing in his rewards. وَمَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ حَرْسَ الدُّنْيَا, and whosoever desires the reward of this world, نُوتِهِ مِنْهَا, we shall give him from this. Okay, you can have a better house, you can have a bigger television set, you can have these things, be happy with these things. نُوتِهِ مِنْهَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ نَصِيبٍ, but for him, and there is no share in the hereafter. There he will be at zero. أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءُ شَرَعُوا لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا لَمْ يَعْذُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ, a very important point. These false gods who were associated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were worshipped. But none of them gave any deen to those who worshipped them. Has Hubble or Lat or Uzza or Manat, have they given you some law, some rules, some guidance? Has some book been revealed from them? Nothing. It's one-way traffic. You are worshipping and worshipping and worshipping. What are you are getting from them? If you worship Allah, He guides you. Allah has given you this book. Allah has given you the law. Allah has given you the perfect political, socio-economic system of justice. أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءُ شَرَعُوا لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا لَمْ يَعْذُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. Do they have such associators with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who have ordained for them a religion for which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not allowed. What means this? None. وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ فَصْلِ لَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ If the word of final judgment had not passed earlier, final judgment will come on the day of judgment, not here. لَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ Then everything could have been decided among them at once. وَإِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ And for these evildoers, there is a very painful chastisement. تَرَى الظَّالِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا كَسَبُوا On that day, on the day of judgment, you will see, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the evildoers will be fearful on account of what they had earned. They knew it. What we did in the life of the world, everybody knows. بَلِلْ إِنسَانُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسَهِ بَشِيرًا وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرًا Everybody knows where he stands. So they will be fearful what is going to happen to them. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ On the other hand, those who had believed and who had done good deeds, فِي رَوْزَاتٍ جَنَّاتٍ They will be in the meadows of the gardens. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاؤُونَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ For them there will be everything that they will desire. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْكَبِيرُ Definitely, this is the greatest bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكَ الَّذِي يُبَشِّرُ اللَّهُ عِبَادَهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا This is the reward which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given glad tidings to those servants of His who came to believe and did good deeds. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا Say to these people of Makkah and Arabia, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I don't demand from you any wages, any labor, any reward from the services that I am rendering. I'm coming to you, reciting to you these ayat. There were poets in that society. When they recited some poem, they wanted some inam, you know. There should be something. Have I ever asked you for anything? قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى One thing I do ask, and that is, that you should have regard for the kinship. I am a relative of yours. I am from Bani Hashim. And this is a clan of Quraysh. I am a Qarshi. I am from this very land, Makkah. I am the son of this soil. At least if you don't accept me, if you don't accept my dawah, don't oppose me. Don't call bad names for me. Don't say I am a Majnoon. I am crazy. I am a liar. I am taking a dictation from somebody and then saying that this is a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At least you should have regard of the relationship which I have with you. وَمَنْ يَقْتَرِفْ حَسَنَةً And whosoever scores a good deed, if somebody from among you supports me, helps me, نَزِدْ لَهُ فِيهَا حُسْنَا We shall increase for him in it goodness, virtues. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ Verily, Allah is forgiving and appreciating. أَمْ يَقُولُ الْفْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَثِبًا Do they say that he has forged a lie on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That is, he has composed this Quran himself and he's saying this is being revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنْ يَشَئِ اللَّهُ يَقْتِمْ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ So if Allah wishes, O Muhammad, he can put a seal on your heart, then nothing will come. Because heart is the place where Quran descends. فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ This Quran was revealed to the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If a seal is put, this will finish. Allah can do it. We had this ayah, you know, in Surah Bani Israel. وَلَإِنْ شَيْنَا نَنَزْهَبَنَّ بِالَّذِي أَوْحِنَا إِلَيْكَ If we wish, we can take away from you the revelation we have already given you. And here it is being said, that if we wish, we can put a seal on your heart. وَيَمْحُ اللَّهُ الْبَاطِلِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blots out the falsehood. وَيُحِقُّ الْحَقَّ بِكَلِمَاتِهِ And He proves the truth to be true with His commands, His words. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ Verily He knows what is there in the hearts and minds of the people. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ عَنِ عِبَادِهِ And He is who? Accepts the repentance from his bondsmen and servants. وَيَعْفُ عَنِ السَّيِّئَاتِ And he pardons evil deeds. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ He very well knows what you are doing. وَيَسْتَجِيبُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ And he answers the prayers of those who believe and who do good deeds. وَيَزِيدُهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ Whatever they want, ask for, I give them. And I add to it from my own bounty. وَالْكَافِرُونَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ As for those disbelievers who are rejecting this, for them is a severe chastisement. وَلَوْ بَسَطَ اللَّهُ رِزْقَ لِعْبَادِهِ لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had expanded the sustenance for the people in this world, plenty of everything for everybody, لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ Then they would have revolted and rebelled in this land. Now they have to, somehow, sometime they have to ask me, Oh Allah, give me food. Oh Allah, give me this. But had we provided them everything in plenty, nobody would have ever turned his face towards us. لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَاكِنْ يُنَزِّلُ بِقَدْرِ مَا يَشَاءُ Nay, he sends with estimates and measure whatever he wishes. إِنَّهُ بِعِبَادِهِ خَبِيرٌ بَصِيرٌ Verily, he is with his servants, خَبِير. He is aware of their conditions. And he is seeing them. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا قَنَطُوا And he is Allah, who sends down the rain after they become despaired, drought. Rain has not come. Our fields will remain barren. But then rain comes. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا قَنَطُوا Point is despaired. But then Allah sends down rain. وَيَنْشُرُ رَحْمَتَهُ And He spreads His mercy. وَهُوَ الْوَلِيُّ الْحَمِيدِ And He is the protector and praiseworthy. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ Among His signs are the creation of heaven and earth. وَمَا بَصَّ فِيهِمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ And the moving creatures which He has spread in both. In the heavens also, the malaika, the angels, they are moving about. On the earth, all types of animals, then human beings. وَبَصَّ فِيهِمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ جَمْعِهِمْ اِذَا يَشَاءُ قَدِيرٌ Whosoever has spread them, he can collect them also. One day will come, he will gather them all, and he is powerful over it. وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ Whatever affliction or misfortune comes upon you, It is due to what your own hands have earned. وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٌ And he pardons also a lot of it. Lot of your mistakes and sins, Allah pardons. But some of these things, you know, in this very world, you are given some punishment. وَمَا أَنْتُمْ بِمُوْجِدِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ You cannot defeat us, defeat Allah in the land, in the earth, وَمَا لَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ Nor there is for you any protector or helper besides Allah. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ الْجَوَارِ فِي الْبَحْرِ كَالْعَلَامِ From His signs is another one. The ships like mountains, and they are sailing upon the seas. إِنْ يَشَى يُسْكِنِ الْرِيحَ If Allah decides, He can cause the wind to stop. You know, those were the days when, you know, the steamships were not there, and now we have very big ships. But when only the wind was the means, and badbani kashtiya jab hoti thi, to usme kaha, in yasha yuskin rih, if he likes, he can cause the wind to stop. Fayadlalna rawaqid ala zahre. So your boats and ships would stand motionless on the surface of water. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ And this are the signs for those people who are persevering and grateful. أَوْ يُوبِقُهُنَّ بِمَا كَسَبُوا Or he can drown them, drown the ships due to what they have earned. وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَسِيرٍ But he pardons a lot. وَيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ يُجَادِلُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا So that people who argue and dispute our revelations, they will come to know مَا لَهُمْ مِنْ مَحِيسٍ They will have no escape. When you know the ship drowns, no escape. Now, 8 ayat are coming, and they are again very important regarding the axis of this surah. Iqamatuddin, the struggle for Iqamatuddin. Now whosoever makes a decision, he devotes himself for the struggle, there are certain qualities that he should produce in him. Some characteristics of character, everybody cannot do. You have to qualify first. So what are those qualities? You can count. Number one, فَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّن شَيْءٍ فَمَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Whatsoever you are given in this world, take it that it is only a means of living in this world. It's not the real wealth. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. What is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is much better and lasting for those who believe in Allah. You know, this world should become small in their eyes. It should not be the objective of human beings to get this world. No, it's very small. Allah has made me very great. Allah bore all the angels before me. What is this world for me? إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا خُلِقَتْ لَكُمْ. This is the hadith. This world has been created for you. And you have been created. وَأَنْتُمْ خُلِقْتُمْ لِلْآخِرَةِ. You have been created for Akhirah. This world is nothing. This is for you already. He has subjected to you everything which is here. Serving you. The sun, the moon, the stars, everything. So, number one is that one should understand. The importance of this worldly wealth should diminish in his eyes. And he should fix his gaze on the blessings of Akhirah. Number two, وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. They should put their trust wholly and solely in Allah. Not, I can do it. No, no. My trust is in only Allah. I can try, but the result will be in the hands of Allah. I can't do anything without His support, without His help. Tawakkul totally on Allah. Do whatever you can. Don't sit down. Do whatever you can. But your trust should not be in the material means that you have gathered or your own intelligence. No. Trust in God. Number three. وَالَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِثْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشِ. And those who shun the heinous sins and indecencies. The bigger crimes. There are smaller crimes also. Don't worry for them. Allah will wash them off. Bigger crimes, shirk, killing anybody, adultery, telling a lie. These are the things, biggest crimes. If you shun these bigger crimes and the indecencies, fahsha, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep on washing your smaller crimes. This subject has been repeated in the Quran thrice. And this is very important. There are, you might have seen certain people who become very conscious of the small things, trivial things. But if you look deep into their lives, they are very cautious of the trivial things, but the bigger sins, they are continuing. They are involved in riba, the biggest haram in Islam. But for smaller things, they are fighting with each other. This is a special character, traditional religious people. But here what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to us? You take care of the bigger things, the bigger crimes, the bigger muharramat, and I'll wash off your smaller crimes. This is in Surah An-Nisa, and then finally in Surah An-Najm, in the 27th part of Quran. Number four, وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُوهُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. And when they become angry, they pardon and forgive. For a da'i, it is very essential. If you say, I have to take the revenge, he has done this thing all to me, I must give And they reply the same coin, well then you are not a da'i. For da'is, it is necessary. Take verbal persecution. And you just take them patiently and forgive people. As you have heard so many times, the prayer of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma aghfir qawmi, Allahumma ahdi qawmi, innahum la ya'lamun. Oh my Lord, just give guidance to these people of mine. Whatever they are doing, they don't know what they are doing. They are stoning me. They are throwing stones on me. But oh Allah, they don't know what they are doing. So give them the guidance. وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُوهُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ Number 5. وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ Those who respond to the call of their Lord. And what is the call of the Lord? In this surah only one call of the Lord has come. أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ Did you have any iqabat us-salat here? Up till now not. Now it will come. But up till now not. The only call is an aqimuddin. The only thing forbidden, wala tatafarraqu fi. Regarding deen and establishment of deen, you shouldn't differ. But regarding the details of sharia, you can have differences of opinion. No harm. Fiqh-e Hanafi and fiqh-e Maliki and so on, no harm. But deen is the same. And the struggle of iqamatuddin, that should be joint. وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ They say, لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ We are present. I devote myself to the struggle of establishment of your deen. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accept me. وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ وَاقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ Knock out and establish prayer. To have a direct contact and strong contact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this 5 times prayer a day is most essential. Because in this worldly business, you get lost. You just forget. You have to renew your pledge. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. A very beautiful couplet of Hafiz Jalandhari. Sarkashi ne kar diye dhundle nukushe bandagi. The arrogance within me have made the marks of my bondsmanhood, there were the marks that I am the bondman of Allah. But due to arrogance, they have been washed off. Aao sajde mein gire, lohe jabi taza kare. Let us prostrate before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have that imprint of the bondsmanship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala renewed on our foreheads. Aao sajde mein gire, lohe jabi taza kare. وَأَمْرُهُمْ شُورَى بَيْنَهُمْ Number 7. And they have to decide their matters by mutual consultation. No authoritarianism. Nobody should say that I am the total wisdom and total knowledge. No, no. You have to consult with each other. The party affairs should be done by mutual consultation. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ And whatever we have given to them, they spent. For every struggle, you need money. To establish the deen of Allah, you need money. To go to war for the cause of Allah, you need money. For weapons, for rations, everything. For the propagation, you need money. وَمِن مَا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ These 3 ayat on this subject, again let me say, are the most profound ayat. Ayat 13, 14, 15, then ayat 36, 37, 38. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْبَغْيُهُمْ يَنْتَصِرُونَ But now something different is coming. And those whom, if there is something wrong done to them, they take revenge. This is contrary to what we have been talking before. In Surah Hamim Sajda, idfa billati ahsan. You have to forgive. But here, because this is the Surah of Iqamatuddin. Iqamatuddin means Iqamat of justice, establishment of justice. and that justice requires that if something wrong is done to somebody, he can take revenge. وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقِصَاصِ حَيَاتٌ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. When their system will be established, there will be a system of qisas, revenge. If somebody has murdered somebody, he should lose his life. Or be only the wali of the person who was murdered. He can pardon him, nobody else. No head of the state has the power or authority to pardon him. So, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَهُ بَغْيُهُمْ يَنْتَصِرُونَ. There's nothing bad in it. وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. And the reward of an evil thing is an evil thing equal to it. Don't go beyond it. What injury he has given to you, the same you can give to your to other person, not more than that. فَمَنْ أَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ. Now persuasion. But whosoever pardons and makes peace, فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. His reward is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الظَّالِمِينَ. Verily he doesn't like and love the evil doers. وَلَا مَنْ انْتَصَرَ بَعْدَ ظُلْمِهِ. Anyhow, whosoever takes revenge after he was wronged, فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. There is no way of blame to them. You can't say that you have done something wrong. No, it is his right. If he demands revenge, it is his right. وَلَمَنْ انْتَصَرَ بَعْدَ ظُلْمِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. إِنَّمَا السَّبِيلُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ. The blame is for those الَّذِينَ يَظْلِمُونَ النَّاسِ, who oppress mankind. وَيَبْغُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. And they rebel in the earth wrongly. They become the exploiters. They become the oppressors. We are high up, you are low. We are Brahmins, you are Shudra. Who are you? You can't even hear the words of scriptures. If by chance a word of the Hindu scriptures passes into the ear of a Shudra, you know, molten lead will be thrown in the ear and make him deaf. Oh, all human beings by birth are equal. No higher, no lower. No superior, no inferior. No high, no low. So this injustices on the basis of the color of the skin, on the basis of races, on the basis of professions. It's a menial profession, no. Any labor, it should be respectful. He's working. And you know, whosoever earns his livelihood by working by hand, the Prophet had said, he is the best earner. He works with the hand. إِنَّمَا السَّبِيلُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ يَظْلِمُونَ النَّاسَ وَيَبْغُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. The blame is to those who oppress the people and they rebel in the land without any right. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. For them, there is a very painful chastisement. إِنَّمَا السَّبِيلُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ. In the end again. But whosoever takes it patiently and forgives. إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ مِنْ عَظْمِ الْأُمُورِ. Now this is of very high level. This is a very strong character is needed for this. To forgive, then you can take the revenge. If you can't take the revenge, well, what you can do? Nothing. But if you can take the revenge, and then you don't, and you pardon, and you forgive, and you make peace, it's of a very high character. وَمَنْ يُضْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. And whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent astray, you won't find for him, after him, any protector. وَتَرَى الظَّالِمِينَ لَمَّا رَعَوُ الْعَذَابِ. And you will see these evildoers. When they will see the chastisement before their eyes, يَخُولُونَ هَلْ إِلَىٰ مَرَدٍ مِّنْ سَبِيلٍ. They will say, is there any way to give back? وَتَرَاهُمْ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا. You will see them. They will be presented to the fire. This is the hell and they are standing. خَاشِعِينَ مِنَ الظُّلِّ. And they will be humbled with disgrace. Yandruguna min tarfin khafi. They will only be having a stealthy glance, seeing from the corner. Can't lift their eyes. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا And then those who had believed, they would say, إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Verily, the real losers are those who made themselves the losers, and not only themselves, also their families. Because their families are with them. They were going on the same road. So they have brought them also to the greatest loss. Ala inna zalimina fi azami muqeem. Behold, these evildoers will be in a lasting chastisement. Wama kana lahum min awliya, and they will not have any protectors, yansurunahum min dunillah, who will be able to help them besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Waman yudillahu fama lahu min sabil, and whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent astray, he will not find any way for him. Now the two ayat again of the same importance. 3 plus 3 and now 2. Istajibu li rabbikum. Say yes to the call of Allah. Say labbaik to the call of Allah. Answer the call of your Lord. And what is the call? An aqimu ad-deen wa la tatafarraqu fi. All the other things are subservient to this. The call basically is in ayah number 13. Shara lakum min ad-deen ma wasa bihi Nuhan wal ladhi awhayna ilayk wa ma wasayna bihi Ibrahim wa Musa wa Isa an aqimu ad-deen wa la tatafarraqu fi. Istajibu li rabbikum. Respond positively to the call of your Lord. Min qabli an yatiya yawman. Before that time, that day comes, لا مرد له من الله. That time comes by the command of Allah, which will not be able to be turned back. It can mean your death, the day of your death. When that comes, it won't go back. And the hour for the whole world. ما لكم من ملجئ يومئذ. That day you will not have any refuge. وما لكم من نكير. And there will not be possible any denial from your side that we didn't do it. Oh, okay. Iqra kitabak, kafa bi nafsika al-yawma alayka hasiba. And as I said, one button pushed, and the whole film of his whole life will come to start. Today we can understand these things very easily. Fa in aradu. But then, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if they don't call back, don't respond to your call. Don't say labbaik to Allah. فَإِنَارَدُوا If they turn away, فَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَفِيظًا So we have not sent you over guard. You are not responsible. إِنْ عَلَيْكَ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغِ There is no responsibility on you except the conveying of the message. وَإِنَّا إِذَا أَذَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنَّا رَحْمَةً And the strange thing is, that when we make man taste our mercy, فَرِحَ بِهَا He rejoices with it. وَإِن تُصِبْهُمْ سَيِّئَةٌ And if something bad comes to them, بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ Due to what their own hands have sent forward, فَإِنَ الْإِنسَانَ كَفُورٌ Then this man becomes totally ungrateful. لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ The concluding ayat of this surah, Very profound. لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ To Allah belongs the sovereignty and kingdom of the heavens and the earth. يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ He creates whatever He likes. يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثًا He gives only daughters to whom He wishes. وَيَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ الذَّكُورَ And to whom He wishes, He gives sons only, no daughter. أَوْ يُزَوِّجُهُمْ ذُكْرَانًا وَإِنَاثًا Or He mingles them males and females, daughters and sons both. وَيَجَعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَقِيمًا And He makes whomsoever He likes barren, no son, no daughter. Having gone to all the corners of the world, all treatments, No way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not given you. Innahu alimun qadir. Verily, He is all-knowing, all-powerful. وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ Now is coming, you know, the subject of wahi. وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمَهُ اللَّهُ The position of man is not such that Allah should talk to him. Allah can talk to him. Allah is all-powerful. But Allah is very high, you are very low. It's not for you that Allah should talk to you directly. Illa wahyan. There are three ways of communication, divine communication to human beings. Number one, wahyan. Direct inspiration into the heart of the people. Aw min wara'i hijab. Or from behind a curtain. Just as Allah talked to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Aw yursila rasulan. So number three, or he sends a messenger, an angel. فَيُوْحِيَ بِإِذْنِهِ مَا يَشَاءُ And then he reveals to that person whatever Allah desires. So three modes. Direct wahi of Allah, direct inspiration. We call it inspiration. And we have other words also, ilham, ilqa. Something comes to your mind suddenly, you don't know. The sixth sense, the intuition. You call, you give them different names. Something has come to you. And you are yourself surprised. I was not thinking about it. I had not gathered the arguments for and against and weighed them against each other. No, it has come to my mind. So this ilqa, ilham, these things are direct inspiration from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The number two is Allah speaks from behind a curtain as He spoke to Moses. And three is And Allah sends an angel as a messenger, and he then reveals to the human messenger whatever Allah wishes. So this wahi is the third form of wahi, this Quran. وَكَذَالِكَ Now this word كَذَالِكَ appears for the third time. Twice we had in the very beginning. كَذَالِكَ يُوحِي إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ وَكَذَالِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ قرآن عربيا لتنذر أم القرى ومن حولها كذلك in this way O Muhammad in this third way O Muhammad we have revealed down and sent down this book to you وكذلك وحينا إليك روحا من أمرنا now this wahi is called روح I have told you the angel is روح الروح القدس روح الأمين the روح the spirit of Muhammad is روح and the communication between the angel and the spirit human spirit is روح Ruham min amrina, from our command. This is from Alam-e Amr. These three things belong to Alam-e Amr. Now all people can't understand this. We have discussed these things many a times during this month. وَكَذَلِكَ وَحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِيمَ الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ O Muhammad, you never knew what is book and what is Iman. You were born To an illiterate people, you were yourself unlettered one. There was no book with your family, your nation, your people. You never learned reading and writing. You never knew what is the book, Allah book. And what's Iman? مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِيمَ الْكِتَابَ وَلَا الْإِيمَانَ Very important ayah. Even Muhammad got Iman from Quran. Before the revelation of Quran, O Muhammad, you never knew what is book and what is Iman. وَلَاكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا We have made this Quran the light. نَهْدِ بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا And we guide with this whomsoever we like from our servants. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمٍ And now that Quran has come to you and your spirit is fully lightened by this light of Quran. Now you will lead the people to the straight path. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي Now, because you have this Quran. This Quran has permeated each and every cell of your existence. You are actually Quran. As Hazrat Aisha said, when you know people went to her, رضي الله تعالى عنها, and they said, tell us something about the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And she retorted, don't you read Quran? They said, Ummul Mu'mineen, we read Quran very well, but we are asking for seerah. And then she replied, Kana khulukul Quran. His character is Quran, his seerah is Quran. He was Quran in the form of a human flesh and bone, Quran itself. So now you can lead people to the right path. Siratillahi allazi lahu ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ard. And what is meant by the right path? Right of the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To whom belong whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. Ala ilallahi tasirul umur. Behold, to Allah will be returned all the matters for the final judgment. Everything will be presented before Him on the day of judgment.